Hey makers, Ravi here. And this is a very, very quick video to show you how to use SSH. SSH stands for Secure Shell and it is an encrypted network protocol that lets you run commands on remote devices. It is very handy for any projects that don't necessarily have their own display and keyboard and mouse. I'll be using a Raspberry Pi 2 here as an example, but the processor is same for all the devices. You need to enable SSH on the remote device, get its IP address, and then log in from your main machine. So let's see how to do this on the Raspberry Pi.
First of all, we need to enable SSH on the Pi. So connect it up. Initially, we need to connect a display as well as a keyboard, but we won't need them later on. I am currently using the Raspbian OS for the Pi. To see how to install it, check out this video. A link will also be in the description. Power on your Pi and log in. Now run the command sudo raspi config. You can also run this command from the terminal if you are in the desktop environment. This will open up the configuration tool. When you are in this menu, go to the advanced options and hit enter.
You will see SSH as the fourth option.
Highlight it and hit enter and select enable. The Pi will enable SSH and when it's done, it will take you back to the configuration tool.
Select finish by using the right arrow key.
Now we need to get the IP address of the Pi. Type ifconfig and hit enter. Some network info will come up. The address in front of inetadder is your IP address. Note it down. If you haven't given your Pi a static IP, then this would be a good time. Check out this video to see how to do it. A link will be in the description. Without a static IP, you will have to check the IP every time you turn on the Pi. Now you can remove the display as well as the keyboard and mouse. We won't need those henceforth. Now get on a computer which is on the same network as the Pi. First of all, you need to get a SSH client. The most popular one right now is PuTTY. It is easy and simple as well as feature rich. The download link would be in the description. It will be an .exe file and doesn't need any installation. Now run this .exe file and enter the IP address of your Pi in the IP text box and click open. A window will come up very similar to the command line on the Pi. You are now successfully SSH'd into the Pi. You can log in using the username Pi and Raspberry as the password. You can even start multiple sessions and connect to the same device. It will enable you to work in two command lines of the same device at the same time. Since you can control almost all the aspects of the Pi through its command line, you won't need to connect a display to the Pi again for most purposes. What I showed you here only works on your local network. But if you want to control the Pi when you are not on the same network, then you need to enable port forwarding, and that topic deserves its own video. Once you use SSH yourself, you will see how convenient it is. Just plug in Ethernet and power and you are good to go.
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.